go out and do your job much higher at a much higher level.
It's all New Orleans tonight in Tampa Bay at Raymond James Stadium. It's times like these you
learn to live. Gene Dekaroff speaking the truth, the voice of the Bucks. Keyshawn, J. Will, and Zubin. Good Monday morning, fellas. Speaking of Monday, think back to that first Monday after the Bucks lost that first game of the Brady era to the Saints, and we wondered what in the world is wrong with Tom Brady. This Monday morning, another loss to the Saints, and we're wondering what is wrong with Tom Brady. We've come full circle.
I'm just trying to figure out getting through the weekend, man. A good slate of college football. I had a chance to see Clemson lose to Notre Dame, see my Trojans roar back against ASU.
What a win.
Yeah.
What a win for USC.
You know, and then think about my co-host and what they might have been doing over the weekend. And then I eventually got to the NFL football, you know. But that's been my weekend.
I appreciate the cooking video you sent me. I love that you forgot. You're chopping up some carrots.
Was it some carrots I was chopping up?
Yeah. I mean, you always sending me cooking videos. I swear you need to have your own cooking show.
I was trying to teach you a little something. That way, you know what I'm saying, Zubin? If you reply back to us on our group text, then you can see some stuff too.
Don't hold your breath on that. Just being honest with you. You're rubbing off on me. That pure honesty is rubbing off on me.
I just want you to know, Zubin, I have a victim complex.
What's going on?
Because I'm a victim of wanting to believe in the Bucks and Tom Brady. And Key just poured gasoline all over the fire because I know he's going to continue to burn it out today. So
no,
Keyshawn was right. I concede he was right about the Saints.
Well, let's not do that yet. But what I would say is, you know, you watch that game last night, obviously, and another slate of games yesterday was pretty good. Quarterback play at times is up and down, depending on the games you were watching. But when you look at the Saints and you look at the Bucks, I think everybody assumed that the Bucks had the better defense, and everybody assumed that the Saints' offense was okay. But if you go man for man, Bucks offense, Saints offense, you go man for man, pick and choose. You pick and choose who you really want from which team and see what you come up with. That's what you got from the Saints. They inserted Michael Thomas into the lineup yesterday, and they got this jolt of Snack, Crackle, Pop, star power. We got our guy. You could clearly see the confidence in Drew Brees with having him and Emmanuel Sanders out on the field. Clearly.
So I walked away from this game saying, what the hell happened to this vaunted Tampa Bay defense that I've been reading about, that I've been seeing play? I mean, you think about Tampa Bay's opponents have an 82.9 quarterback rating, Key. It's considered one of the best defense. And I watched Drew Brees last night sit there and just destroy them for four TDs. And I watched him go through all of his options, and I know that you said their personnel on paper is better than what Tampa Bay has, but it seemed like that defense did nothing for Tom Brady. Tom Brady's a different conversation, but that defense was nowhere to be found last night.
Well, I think when you look at from a personnel standpoint, though, for New Orleans offense, the matchups. When was the last time the Bucs faced an offense that had somebody at every single position? You got Alvin Kamara in the back. You got Murray in the back. You also got Michael Thomas, Emmanuel Sanders. I mean, you got Cook, the tight end. I mean, there are pieces that's there, and I think a lot of people got caught up in the Antonio Brown hype machine coming with Tom Brady along with Mike Evans and Chris Godwin and Gronkowski, and so they start looking at those nameplates and forgetting that other side and that other team got some nameplates too.
There's no doubt about it. Think about it. Last night, fully stacked, Drew Brees, Michael Thomas, Emmanuel Sanders, Tre'Quan Smith, Deontay Harris, Taysom Hill, Alvin Kamara, Jared Cook.
I didn't even mention Taysom Hill.
Man,
I didn't even mention that, right? And so when you look at those names, those are nameplates too. But everybody gets caught up in the Leonard Fournette's, and everybody get caught up in the Mike Evans. But they got to realize Sean Payton is a play caller too and knows what to do with guys. As long as he doesn't get cute, because Sean has the tendency at times to start calling plays that make you go, Sean, what are you doing? You know, and so last night he did not do that. Last night I thought he called a hell of a football game. He utilized Taysom Hill when he needed to, even to the point where Taysom Hill throws a deep crosser to the tight end, which I didn't think he was going to do when he got in there, and neither did the Bucks. That's why the tight end was wide open, because the Bucks anticipated, okay, all he's going to do is drop back, fake like he's going to throw, and then take off and run. He dropped back and actually ripped it.
Key, take me through, so for Tom Brady, because I know he threw three picks last night. He wasn't vintage Tom Brady. But it seemed like one of those picks was just a horrible pass. The last pick just seemed like it was a really bad pass.
I might have been
the first one got tipped.
He might have been sleeping on.
Yeah, the first one got tipped up. The second one seems like there was miscommunication between him and Antonio Brown.
The tip was a good play by the defensive lineman. That was just a good play.
The second one was Antonio Brown. Seemed like he stopped.
That could be miscommunication. You think about it, Jay, and we were talking in our pre-production meeting, and as I looked down the stat line, prior to looking, just my eyes telling me early on in the game, they were trying to get Antonio Brown involved, in my opinion, too much. Too much. To the point where you got Chris Godwin, you got Mike Evans with 6 targets, and here it is, Antonio Brown with 5 targets. Mm. It's like, well, wait a minute, man. He only been here a week. You should be force-feeding those other guys the football and kind of just letting Antonio kind of just get his feet underneath him. Early in the game, they tried him on a deep post, which was a good shot. Tom Brady almost got it picked off, a little slightly underthrown, but Antonio Brown didn't clear the defender enough for Tom to even be throwing that football. If there's any other quarterback in the National Football League taking that shot with that particular receiver, he's being ridiculed because Tom probably shouldn't have thrown that ball. In my opinion, there's no way he should have thrown that ball.
Key, this is going to sound
he wasn't clearly open.
It's going to sound like a crazy comment, but hear me out on this one. If you live with somebody, does that put subliminal pressure on you to a degree to like you need? Think about Zubin for a minute.
Like,
I never lived with somebody either. Not
You're
as a grown man.
The
but
fact that AB is living with Brady.
Does
at the
that put some kind of subliminal pressure on you to out of the gate make it work a little bit more? Considering, look, this is somebody I have a lot of familiarity with. We're around each other all the time now. We're trying to build upon that camaraderie. Like to a degree, it has to some degree, right?
I don't know that Antonio Brown is a hell of a football player. That's the pressure. The pressure is that he's good. That you want to get. You know, you want to get the ball in his hands. You think about what he did in his first game against the Miami Dolphins when he was with the New England Patriots. They put an emphasis, Belichick and Josh McDaniel and Tom Brady put an emphasis on getting him involved because that's what happens usually when someone acquires a new toy, whether it's the Kansas City Chiefs and Le'Veon Bell. The moment that Le'Veon Bell was available to them, they start utilizing him. Mm-hmm. And that's what happens because the guy's a good football player. But sometimes, in my opinion, what you ought to do is use them as a decoy. You don't have to you don't have to force the football to them. I think you get the football to the other guys, and then their stuff will naturally come.
I just don't think I've ever seen Tom Brady have a game like this before. I mean, do you guys remember the last time we've seen Tom Brady have a game? Well, he threw for 0 TDs. 0.
Well, they only scored 3 points.
I know.
And you can't get 3 points by kicking field goal. I mean, by scoring touchdowns, you got to get the 3 by kicking field goals.
So here are the most important numbers if you're just waking up this morning. I want to hear from Bruce Arians, and then I'm just going to rattle off some numbers and get your quick fire analysis. Ready? The most important numbers, 38-3, Saints win if you're just waking up. Michael Thomas, Key's nephew's back, 5 catches, 51 yards. Mm. Antonio Brown, first game back in the NFL, 3 catches, 31 yards. Here's a clearly angry Bruce Arians, and then some really interesting numbers real quick for the fellas.
Second half, I thought we got to turnover and we don't score a touchdown. I thought that kind of was end of it right then and there. But I have to give New Orleans credit. They kicked our ass in every phase.
Bruce Arians never holding back. To Jay's point, real quick analysis, I'll fire through some. Tom Brady, 5 picks this year against the Saints. 5 against the Saints.
Wow. Yeah, because the Saints, it's a division opponent, first of all. And when you have a division opponent, I think I said this last week, as we continue to talk about and rave about the Buccaneers and their offense and what they could do, and it's a division opponent. When you have a division opponent, no matter who the quarterback is, you're going to know in their tendencies and certain things that they do. The Bucs and the Saints play each other twice a year.
Mm-hmm.
Twice a year. And I understand Bruce Arians got a new quarterback, and he just came over a couple years ago. I get all that, but it doesn't matter. I still know those players' pulse.
You see, Zubin, I said I'm a victim to the Tom Brady hype is because Key's been saying this the whole year pretty much about, like, just wait until the Saints get healthy. He's been talking about it. And this whole narrative that's been following Tom about, we know who Tom is in November and December. It's winning time football. To his credit, Key's been on this train the whole time.
No question about
it. Choo-choo.
We should also mention, as we hit the engine for the caboose for the break here, we should mention the Bucs didn't have a first down until the second quarter. Oh. If that tells you how bad the offense was playing. They ran the ball just 5 times. And the most important thing,